Dreamscapers. I stretched my back, pressing the shoot button. Myko, I grunted, scratching my collarbone where my newly blue-tipped hair rested. I think the hair dye is irritating my skin. Myko leaned towards me, sticking her tongue out. Have you ever dyed your hair before?
No.
I frowned, popping my neck. But I thought you said it would be a bit softer.
No.
Myko droned, her character pushing me off a cliff. I said that you would get used to it. And we put a whole bunch of conditioner into the dye. It should be super soft. I shook my head. Yeah, no. My character on the screen swerved into Myko's cart, and she spun out of control. No, 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 no. She wailed, losing to me. I win. I yelled, throwing my hands into the air. Cheater. I did not.
Yes, you did.
I groaned, rolling my eyes. You say this every time. We argued more, our forgotten controllers lying on the table. In the end, we were left on the beanbag, shoving each other's faces into the fabric. Say it. I laughed, pushing her head into the beanbag. Say I'm better than you. Her head lifted forcibly up. Never. She laughed, twisting her body out of my grip. Her force made me fall over on my back, and onto the floor. Oh ouch. I smiled, leaning on my arms. I crawled back onto the beanbag, and shoved Myko off. Bwah! She shouted, waving her arms up and down like a bird as she fell. That's what you get. I smirked, flopping on my back. Let's see what's in the magic bag of wonders. I sang, sticking my hand underneath the beanbag. My hand scrambled under it, and I felt a cube. I grabbed it, and pulled out my hand. A multicolored block of separate cubes rested in my clutch. I grinned, and started twisting the Rubik's Cube's layers, jumbling up the colors. I started humming, hearing the satisfying clicks as the blocks set in place. Optimus, you're not going to believe this. I turned to the green computer, looking at the Earth map. I've just pinpointed the location of the Decepticon warship. Ratchet exclaimed, the screen blipping. Seriously? I asked excitingly, jumping off the bag. How did you penetrate their cloaking technology? Optimus boomed, walking up to the screen with the others. I didn't. Ratchet turned. I was experimenting the variable frequency wavelengths when I stumbled upon it. Even still, their ship must be experiencing some kind of electromagnetic breach. That's because they're over a radiation mine. I pointed out, seeing as their ship was in northern Animalia. The unearthed radioactivity has been known to cause malfunctions in aerial ships and anything electrical nearby. That is why we use plasma as fuel and energy. With Megatron deceased and the element of surprise, RC smirked, slamming her fist into her palm. We could cause some serious damage. Bulkhead finished off. I nodded, looking back up to the map slash backslash. A second blip appeared, a different model of a different ship. Also on the same frequency, Ratchet continued, an Autobot emergency beacon. I squared my shoulders, and squinted at the location. How did it end up in the expanse? I asked myself, pondering on that thought. The Decepticons can wait. Optimus declared. There may be Autobots in distress. Ratchet, bring your medical kit. I turned, hearing the ground bridge open. Optimus, wait. I called to him. Be careful, these deserts are almost as bad as the Black Dew forests. The creatures there are tyrants, and for all I know, much of the land is full of iron fillets. One wrong move and you'll be coming back with no leg. My eyes grew wider with concern, and I tucked a piece of hair behind my ear. Optimus hummed, and nodded. Thank you for the information, Molly. And with that, the leader and the medic walked into the portal. Molly. I turned to Raph. It says here that there are no deserts in that area. Raph pointed to his laptop. How come it is not on a map? Oh, Raph. I smiled at his innocence. Nobody maps Oblivion.
My ringer on my phone went off, and I dove towards it.
Hello? I answered, holding it to my ear.
Molly. Please tell me it's you.
Logan. Is he all right?
He sounds hurt.
These thoughts flew around my head.
Logan. I yelled into the phone. Is everything all right?
Molly. He replied with a shaky but joyous voice. I'm not going to be coming home. Something's happened at the academy. I'll try to get back to you later. Just try not to be mad at me when I get home. If I am not back in 2 days, Callster. A crash came from the other side of the line, shaking the phone.
Logan. Somebody distantly shouted. It's getting bigger. Got to go, Logan shouted.
Wait. He hung up, the call ending with a click.
I, however, did not worry. He has made these calls before, and always overreacts about him over the phone when really they made another living gummy bear. If he is covered in jello when he gets home, I swear.
I breathed, shaking my head.
15 minutes passed, and the comlink went off.
RC. Ratchet yelled urgently, opened the ground bridge.
Now. The stress in his voice made my heart clench. Did something happen? Is Optimus all right?
I bit my tongue, trying to keep my shouting within.
Ratchet carried Optimus back into the room, and Optimus appeared weak.
Oh my God. I panicked, running to the edge.
What happened?
I bit back a scream, yelling those words.
The ship was a crashed plague ship.
Ratchet rushed, infected energon dripped into his optic.
I bit my lip, holding back tears.
Optimus's optic flickered, the area around turning a bruise color.
Ratchet was holding a scanner up to his facial plates, the needle shaking at the highest level.
Cybonic plague.
Ratchet confirmed. It's only contagious if contact is made with the infected energon.
I breathed in hesitantly, keeping close to Optimus.
What was a plague doing in an Autobot ship? Miko asked, voice soft.
I shook my head, my shoulder slumped. The room was duller, and the vile sense of dread blanketed the area.
Chills ran up my spine, like a reaper was standing over
our shoulders, waiting, feeding.
Its passengers were infected.
RC answered Miko.
The virus wiped out millions on Cybertron during the Great War.
I gulped, swallowing back saliva.
How would this happen? I thought, clenching my fingers around the rail.
Cybonic plague was engineered in the Decepticons' biological warfare program. Ratchet turned to us, a grave look in his optics, by Megatron himself.
I breathed in quickly, my back straightening. When I breathed back out, it came out in rolls, like a faint growl escaping my lips.
Please tell me that it is not like a bubonic plague.
Please, if any gods are out there, please tell me it is not in any case like the bubonic plague.
I begged, squeezing my eyes shut.
You, Raph gulped, have a cure, don't you?
Optimus stirred, and I looked back down at him.
No cure. He groaned, looking to us.
SHHHH.
I hushed softly, save your strength, Optimus.
I walked closer, sitting on the edge.
Jack butted in, would Megatron create a disease without having a cure?
Your kind did. I growled quietly, giving Jack a glare.
That's all you humans have been doing.
I mean, Jack continued, without hearing any of my words. What if he caught it by accident?
It's not like we can ask Megatron, Jack. Bulkhead pointed out.
Technically, we can but I think that introducing the humans to the demon dimension would cause them to start questioning their faiths.
I thought, looking at them talk.
He's pushing up lug nuts.
But, Ratchet included, we might be able to access the Decepticon database. For the moment, we still have a fix on their warship's location.
I sighed, standing up. If they were heading over Animalia, into rock territory, someone has to go.
Hell, who am I kidding?
I am going for Optimus's sake.
Bumblebee, come with.
RC waved, heading towards the ground bridge.
I'm coming. I blurted, pulling my shoulders back. I started treading to the bridge, but turned my head. Molly, Optimus groaned, gazing at me longingly. Don't go. I'm sorry, Optimus. I assured, softly, but I won't be long. I looked back to the ground bridge, choking back tears that wanted to trail down my face. Bussy, quickly. Ratchet called to us. I softly blinked my eyes, before heading in. B and RC transformed, and I sprinted beside them. The bridge opened up on the other side, and I prepared to be greeted by dank, dark halls. I dove through, unsheathing my claws with a metallic shing. I landed softly onto the floor, scanning the empty corridors. Let's start with the labs, RC suggested, stalking forwards with her blasters at the ready. I nodded, following them. My claws were kept out, since I haven't felt any comfort for this ship since the experiments. Quickly, we found our way to the lab. I sighed in relief, but then the door hissed open. In a flash, I was on the ceiling, claws keeping me in place. Knockout walked out of the room, doors closing behind him. I looked to RC, who was balancing herself in between the wall and a beam. I gasped, Knockout stopping to look around. But, to my content, he shrugged and went on his way. Phew. I breathed, leaping down from the ceiling. The doors opened in front of us, and our shadows loomed into the room. RC zoomed to the screens to our left, while I looked around the labs. It wasn't the same room with the cage. I'm in, RC hummed, typing into a keyboard. Another chill ran up and down my spine like rats, and I turned abruptly. We are not alone, I growled, squinting my eyes. If it's here, I don't see it. RC hummed back to Ratchet. I've searched every file. Nothing. I heard Ratchet's voice, then RC's yelling. I scanned the entire database. Bumblebee buzzed, looking through another door. What is it, B? I asked, then looked through the window. Oh no. I gasped, hearing RC walk up as well. How the hell? I pondered, walking into the open room. Megatron's half-dead body lied on a berth, only living because of the life support systems connected to him. One swipe and he's dead. I glowered, sheathing my metal shears back into my fist. It's Megatron. I combed back to base. He apostrophe s dot 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 alive. RC finished, scowling in disgust. Partially alive. I corrected, looking at the medical report. His sparks still beating, and his brain waves are still bouncing, but everything else is dead. Much like a chupacabra. That can't be possible. Ratchet gasped, and I shook my head. Well, we're staring right at him. I talked back, stalking around that huge berth. His chest rose and fell, like he was breathing. My lips pulled back in a snarl, the faint scent of mid-death creeping into my nose. He's critical, RC informed, hooked up to life support. Her blaster aimed at his spark, and as selfish as it sounded, I couldn't let her do it. He might have been the only being strong enough to take me on, and odd as it sounds, I've been aching for another fight. Time to finish this, once and for all. RC's blaster charged up. Wait. Don't Ratchet yelled into both of our comlinks. One good reason fast. Megatron may be Optimus' only hope for survival. I stood straight, keeping my hands to my sides in clenched fists. Active brain waves. He is still in the mindscape. I realized, looking to the body of the warlord. What are you talking about? RC asked, though. I wasn't quite surprised. Megatron may be cruel, but he is definitely not stupid. He did make a cure, but kept it to himself. Ruthless enough to let even his own die of the disease. I smirked, ruthless enough to kill billions. Does he display brainwave activity? Ratchet asked, and RC looked to the screens. Yes. I answered, putting a finger to my ear, and spiking incredibly. His sick mind still at work. RC growled. RC, I laughed, Don't call him sick. That makes it seem like there is a cure. I scrunched up my nose, standing straighter. Perfect! Ratchet exclaimed, to their surprise. If a cure exists, Megatron may be the only one who know it. You must enter his brain. And find it. Hell no! I shouted into the comm. I have done enough mind jumping to know that it screws you up. A few more and I'm going to end up in the psychiatric ward. Wait ... scratch that. I'm already supposed to be in the psychiatric ward. I'm in. Enter Megatron's brain? RC questioned Ratchet, ignoring my comment. Ratchet, are you out of your fragging mind? No, I snarked uncontrollably, but I'm gonna be. I whispered that, snickering at my pun. The Decepticon laboratory should contain all the equipment you need for a cortical psychic patch. Ratchet exclaimed. That sounds interesting. I hummed, and took a lap around the berth. I took in the individual wires that hooked up to the life support, and saw that one was on the fritz. Bingo. I popped. But then, something interesting popped into my ear. What? I questioned, you guys aren't legally supposed to cross into the mindscape. I was dumbfounded. The mindscape is allowed to be entered by anyone, because there is no training required. All you had to know was the exit from the mindscape to the shade dimension, and how to wake yourself up. Can't we just haul Megatron through the ground bridge, buy us some time to figure this out? RC asked. I snapped. Optimus doesn't have time. I screamed at her, snorting out cold air. Time is one thing that Optimus does not have. Ratchet yelled with me. One of you must try this. I will not. Allow Optimus to pass knowing that Megatron will outlive him. Ratchet, I will lay down my life for Optimus, RC explained, anytime, anywhere. But a mind, body split? Then let me go. I said, sternly. I would risk anything for Optimus, even if it meant tearing my own mind apart. Devil knows I did it once before. So many past lives have gone by, and only two have I put down my own life. Once for the kingdom, and once for a friend. Though I don't remember too far back, I know that if I go insane, it will be for a good purpose. I clenched tears welling in my eyes back, but deep in my mind, I remembered that dream. A heart in my hand, the dragoness terrified face, flames reaching higher, almost like bees were took me away from my searing thoughts. You will? RC asked. I smiled, and started focusing on how I was going to achieve this. We started getting B ready, since all I needed was sleep. RC dragged the connected cable back to where we were hiding. While she connected B in, I was falling fast asleep. I tore out of my body, sitting upright. I smiled, seeing the hazed world. Shade dimension. I smiled, maybe I wasn't going to go insane after all. I looked out of our hiding place, and slid through. Megatron's body was glowing through the haze. Much like mine and many others were. I breathed deeply in. Here we go. I peeled back the dimensional teal like a page, and dove into it. I was floating from the ground, a blue aura surrounding my feet. I seriously love this new power. I hummed, and looked around. The whiteness cleared up, and I stumbled backwards. It was like the inside of a volcanic biome, smoke and melted ... iron, covering the whole place with a smoky mist. Well, every mind is different. I said to myself, and floated to the ground. The blue magic quickly shifted to red, like it was trying to match its surroundings. I looked to my clothes, and shook my head. Since none of the Autobots knew anything about the mindscape, I will have to inform them later about how things go. I snapped my fingers, and my clothes quickly shifted into a smoking black coat with leather pants that were set to fire on the bottom. The sleeves were caught on fire as well, and with every step, my boots sparked and a fiery footprint was left in its wake. It needs just one more thing, I told myself, quietly. With a concentrated thought, a blazing cape of flames trailed behind me. He, glad nothing physically harms you in the mindscape. I smirked, and turned to the newly arrived, B. Ready? I asked, pushing back the eerie feeling. He nodded, and walked to my side. Just telling you, I hummed, nothing can harm you here. It may be Megatron's mind, but he isn't in control of it. Just the part he thinks. If something happens, motion to me and I'll take care of it. B buzzed, acknowledging my words. I believe that he could communicate back to base, which astonished me. I looked back to the background. My back itched, the feeling of uneasiness crawling up my neck. Feathers ruffled, and my cape was set in the middle of soot-black wings, in which the tips of the feathers were set ablaze and their remnants and embers swirled behind me. B beeped, making me look to him. It's the mindscape, B. I assured, I don't feel any pain. B still stared at me with concern, before turning back. I let out a huff. Quickly, you two. Ratchet, come to us, this time, loud and clear in your ears. I know you're in unknown territory, but you must figure out where information might be filed in Megatron's mind. Easy. I scoffed, we just have to get out of the receptacle zone and head into the blockades. There, it's just a matter of finding the memory. And how do you know this? Ratchet asked. Old enemy taught me. I shrugged, trotting up the steps. Then, B froze at the top. Sht. I cursed, B, it's a dream. He's not real. I sprinted the rest of the way. I caught up to B, and froze. An exact model of Optimus stood before us. Seeing this made me want to cry, but a striking pain pierced my eyes. They say that it is scientifically proven that you can't feel a stare, but I immediately jumped to the nearest obstacle. While I did that, B ran up to the apparition. I heard Ratchet explain to B that it wasn't Prime, and it couldn't see nor hear him. Or touch him, in that matter. I exhaled, and took notice of something off. A pair of devilish red optics glared down at us, a cackle filling the mind's barriers. The owner of this sinister dream himself. Megatron. Optimus Prime, he bellowed, your Autobot armies are defeated. Bow before your new master. Never, Megatron. The fake Optimus exclaimed, dully, one shall stand, one shall fall. His voice mimicked my Optimus, and his optics just the same, but neither carried any emotion you would subtly find in the real one. S. What happens when you kill a dream person? Oh, right. They're parat somewhere else. I hummed, poking my head from the rock. So be it. Megatron scowled. This is, like, extreme live-action role-playing. I smirked, watching Megatron leap from his cliff, and charge towards his illusion. I clenched my jaw, feeling the slight increase of flames on my sleeves. I turned my head back, watching the apparition go up in blue-green smoke. I never noticed B was at my side till I heard him shaking in rage. B, I whispered, don't lose yourself. It's just an illusion. Nothing more. B ignored me, glaring at Megatron's dream form. Meshs. I growled, and watched Megatron as well. Oddly enough, even in dream form, he still had the four deep, long gashes in his back that I scratched when we first fought back in Dead Rock Gorge. Weird. Why would he keep those? Surely you could buff them out. A quiver went through the rocks, a form standing up from them. Wow, this dude has some serious revenge issues. I thought with UHMPH, watching the next Optimus say his lines. Megatron, your treachery ends here. It proclaimed, trading out its servo for its sword. Megatron looked about, he had enough of this, and sheathed his blade. His arm cannon charged up, aiming at the clone's body. I tilted my head, spitting hair out of my mouth. B dove forward, much to my demise. Bumblebee. No. I whisper shouted. My eyebrows knitted together, and I rubbed my temples. No one listens to me. I whispered, hissing out the words. I ground my teeth in the back of my mouth, trying not to start screaming at him for his completely idiotic actions. A flash of cool colors blasted towards the vision, racing faster from its owner's gun. Bee jumped in front of the blast, shielding the Dream Optimus. But as per usual, the blast went through Bee, and the apparition dissipated into the dreamscape. "Damn it, Bee!" I cursed, shaking my head. I opened my mouth, but it quickly slammed shut. The Autobot Scout. Megatron smirked. Stars, I would love to scratch that smug look right off of his face. I snarled, keeping my position. The punishment for trespassing in my domain is your destruction. He continued, raising his blade. I can't look. I snickered, covering my face. I peeked through my fingers, just as Megatron's blade went down. Right through Bee's torso. Bee's body rippled like liquid, he the only one here that could not be touched. Bee seemed shocked, and buzzed in confusion. How can this be? Megatron yelled, slashing through him again with a grunt. And again. And again. Yawn dot 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 and again. And again. I smirked, walking around the pile of red stones. You're not wearing phase displacement armor. Megatron exclaimed, circling Bee. Your eyes track my movements, so you're not a hologram. And I do not believe in spirits. Well, you better watch out, cause I am one of many in this damn world. So, tell me, Scout, Megatron scowled, what are you? Not an illusion of the mindscape, for one. I smirked, placing my hands behind my back. Megatron and Bumblebee turned to me, a disgusted look replacing Megatron's sinister glare. I returned the glare, straightening my lips. I imagined myself way more intimidating, and I felt the flames on my clothing grow brighter. Try me. Megatron. We all turned to the toneless voice, and I made a grrr sound. Dream versions of another Optimus, Bulkhead, and Bumblebee. Ooh, paradox. Bee looked to both me and Megatron, buzzing quizzically. I shook my head, watching him scamper over to the clones. Bee. I frowned. Stop it. It ain't working. I narrowed my eyes in annoyance, listening to his buzzes and whirs as he tried, emphasis on tried, to get the illusion's attentions. I swear, I didn't mean to snarl. It just came out like a demonic, guttural noise from the back of my throat. But along with my snarl, came a roar right after. Megatron fired his cannon. The apparitions, pissed as hell. Bee was alongside them, having his tiny guns out. I raised an eyebrow, and hopped into the air. Like a vampire would do in our realm, I was floating in the air, suspended by a thin cloud of swirling red. I looked at my nails, not interested whatsoever in my surroundings. But what Megatron said next made my bones tremble. You are real. He snarled, both of you. They were not. He glared at me with hatred. Yeah, I hissed back, but unlike Bee, I can hurt you. I raised a hand, nails now sharp as knives. Fire spilled into my palm, coating it in a burning torch. I released a booming growl, before a sharp ringing invaded my mind. Don't forget, my dear, I can hurt you too. That voice, it's so dot 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 familiar. I winced in pain, holding my ears. The ringing stopped, allowing me to catch my breath. Laughter took me out of my pain, sweet, dark, evil laughter. A cortical psychic patch. Megatron hummed, how unexpected. He turned to me, his optics returning to show disgust. How an earthling got in is very little of interest to me. He scowled. Funny, cause what I remember is that you wanted to have me as an ally. I thought with a returned grimace, does he not know I have a human form? If this is my subconscious. Megatron looked around, becoming aware. I was thrown back next to Bee by an invisible force, but it wasn't Megatron. What are you doing inside my head? He snarled, eyeing me and Bee in the eye. I flinched, and regained my composure. Oddly enough, Bee avoided looking back at Megatron entirely. Me, however, well, I glared right back into his optics, keeping my ground. I growled deeply, my eyes flaring with unknown fire. It seemed as if Megatron noticed this as well. Even if his face plates showed no recognition of my glare, his optics did only the opposite. In fact, they showed more of an interest than rage. He narrowed his optics, and stepped away. He started circling us, and my wings flared. The only way you could have entered my mind is via cortical psychic patch. But the question remains, he hissed, what happened to me? I smirked, well, after the bridge exploded, you were presumed dead. I thought, trying to keep my reply inside. I tried to remember what I saw in the room. My only guess is that one of you so-called loyal soldiers found you and were forced to bring you back to be put on life support. I gave a fake smile, giving my hair a small flip for drama. Megatron glowered at me, which I happily returned. His optics suddenly widened. The space bridge explosion. There. You go, and yet if you both are in my head, I am not one with the Alls Park. Not yet. I replied, waving my hand, but, seeing as you are stuck here in a coma, it doesn't look like you will be alive for very long. I raised an eyebrow, waiting for a response. I got the most welcoming out of them yet. A shiver down Megatron's spine. So, tell me, Scout, do I still function? He asked me harshly, trying to ignore me. But you know it won't work. Well, obviously, if your mind is still working. I scoffed, because this does not resemble hell to me, even if it is depicted like this in many accounts. I looked around, referring to the fiery surroundings. I heard Ratchet tell B that we were out of time, and I thought rushingly. B, I'll keep him busy, just get the cure and get out. I can find my own way. I thought, trying to reach to B. Well? Megatron snarled, stepping closer. I already told you, yes. I growled, clenching my fists. Megatron narrowed his optics at me, his teeth baring. What did you say? Oh, I fake pouted, did I stutter? Or are you just hard of hearing? I really can't tell. I smirked. That did it. Megatron swung his sword at me, almost catching my cheek. If it wasn't for the return slash that waved off of me and towards him. It was a slash of white fire, cutting across his chassis. Yeah, missed. I smiled, floating on my stomach and resting my chin on my knuckles. What are you? He growled, stumbling backwards. Bat out of hell. I giggled, twirling in the smog. My cape stayed with me as I spun, as did my wings. B buzzed rapidly, looking at me. I know. I whispered, start now, before I can cause any more damage. B nodded, and started explaining. Cybonic plague? Megatron growled in disbelief, someone besides me is unwell? I heard tads of odd concern in his tone, but I ignored it. B hesitated, before nodding. And something clicked for Megatron. Optimus. He realized, and chuckled darkly. Such irony. He cackled, that after ages of endless battles, the mighty Optimus Prime is felled from a simple virus of the distant past. And what makes you think that I would save the life of my oldest enemy? Another Optimus appeared beside us, but was immediately blasted by Megatron. I growled, and cleared my throat. Oddly enough, I am surprised that you said that. I hummed, popping my thumb. Oh, he smirked, putting his servos on his hips, and why so? Because after eons of war, wouldn't you want to finally rid of your nemesis yourself? I asked, clenching my jaw. It takes strength to become evil for good, and only evil knows evil. I silently gulped, holding my hands behind my back. He chuckled, did you not see? I do slay Optimus by my own hand, at will, whenever I desire. But is it enough? Is it the same? I ask darkly. They do not have what you want. They do not have what you want. You want to make them suffer. You want to make him suffer. And to torture one most, you take everything they ever cared about, and tear them from him, leaving him to suffer even more while you finally take revenge. And what tortures one most, but ripping away everything they ever cared about, everything they ever loved and watching them suffer in cowardice as you finally take your rightful place. I grinned evilly. Good girl, now stop talking. I obeyed the voice, and squared my shoulders. Megatron took my words to account, looking up in thought. After our deep history together, Megatron said, to not watch the spark ebb from Optimus' eyes with my very own. He closed his fist. Would be a big disappointment. I pouted. He raised an optical ridge, and held out his palm. A cube of data popped from the middle of his servo. Well played, Earthling. It takes one evil to know another. I smirked, motioning to B. B's optics widened. The chemical formula for the cure you seek, not that I expect you to know how to read it. Megatron hissed. B's servos reached towards it, but Megatron's servo closed quickly around it. Hey. What gives? I snarled. Not yet. Megatron smirked, and how am I to accomplish terminating Optimus as you propose when I'm trapped here in a perpetual daydream? Once you release me from this prison, you will have the cure. He turned his back to us, showing the long gashes. I snarled, blood trickling down my fingers. And why would we do that? I snarled, baring my teeth. You must guarantee my recovery, Megatron smirked, or Optimus fades to gunmetal gray, the real Optimus. I choked on my words, squaring my shoulders. Where did you get those scars? I asked, changing the subject while already knowing the answer. Megatron froze, turning back without haste. A fine warrior who deserves utmost respect. He snarled, glaring up at me. It is a shame she sided with the Autobots. I smirked, and glanced down at my turning translucent skin. Thanks for the compliment. I smiled, and wrapped my fiery wings around me. I heard him yell at me, like he was yelling in shock. Surprise? Anguish. But it was muffled. The world started to spin faster and faster, and the blur of a crumbling world followed by Bee jumping through was blinded in white. Till I crashed down onto hard metal floors of the Mbay. I scrambled up, seeing that Knockout, Soundwave and Starscream were following the cable. Oh no! I screamed, and dove into my body. I jumped up quietly, popping my neck. Bee's helm rolled as RC disconnected him. Echoes were yelled into my brain, like fire. Just reminiscence of his deranged mind. The sound of stilettos clacked above me, and I rushed to my team's side. Hurry, Bee! RC urged, shaking him. RC pulled out her gun, and Bee's optics flickered on. Let's go! I shouted. Starscream bent down to gaze at us, and his optics widened. Wait in. The ground bridge opened, and I sprinted into it. A rumble surged through my body, my head feeling like it was stabbed. A few more steps, I assured myself. The lights blinded me, and I raced up the steps, I found a bucket, and purged my stomach. Ratchet helped Optimus stand up from the berth, and Micah was holding my hair back. That's it. Ratchet calmed, steady. Optimus leaned on the medic's shoulder. I smiled, standing up from my hunched state. It's not like anything was left in there. I walked to the railing, while everyone else was applauding. My eyes softened, half-lidded from the amount of pain my body just went through. My back hurt like hell, my eyes were dried, and my throat was probably the only thing keeping my guts from puring out as well. But I still smiled. Please, Optimus grinned with a nod, save the hero's welcome for my physician. That's my Optimus, I grinned, thinking about others first. Ratchet motioned to Bumblebee. And my scout. Optimus motioned as well. Bee shook his head, and pointed to me instead. You're forgetting about Sicky number 2 over here. I grunted, waving my hand stiffly. Optimus smiled, and Molly. Ha. I laughed, he formally addressed me. Not you too. Me. I jabbed my thumb into the space between my collar. Bone and neck, and froze. Ah. I shouted, kicking out my foot. Then, I stubbed my toe on the rail. Ree. I screamed, holding my foot. Ow, oh, wow, 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 I whimpered, and fell backwards over the hard couch. The breath was knocked out of me, and I lied there, helplessly. Molly? I heard Optimus worry, are you all right? Call the doctor. I wheezed, sticking a finger into the air. Must be something wrong with me. Micah chorused, jumping over the couch and landed on my side. He's a monster, why should I want ya? Jack shouted as well, please tell me, please tell me. They both sang together, he's a monster. He's a monster. Oh. That boy, he's a mother-f-king monster. Raph. We yelled, laughing. He frowned, looking at us indifferently. I'm a 12-year-old in a high school. What do you expect me to do? I laughed, rolling onto my stomach. But something felt strange. And the feeling of dread dug into my ears. I looked from the corner of my eye at B, and something wasn't right with him. I could feel it.
Hey guys, what's going on? Thank you so much for watching today's episode. If you guys want to watch more like it, please subscribe to my channel and become part of the video game fanfiction plot. And please leave a comment down below and hit that like button. If you guys have any suggestions on any stories you guys want me to read, don't hesitate. They're always welcome here in the video game fanfic plot. That also goes for video games. Until next time, goodbye!